In this video, I will show you how to make a connecting rod assembly. Before that one, you need to make a connecting rod part. So in this video, I am showing you how to make the connecting rod part using SOLIDWORKS software. Disclaimer. This PPT has been prepared by referring many sources, which include figures, diagrams from internet, as well as from the prescribed textbooks and reference books. I do not claim any originality in preparing this video or PPT. This PPT or video is exclusively for purpose of education, not for any financial gains. I wholeheartedly thank all those who have directly or indirectly contributed to do this PPT and video. Next assembly is connecting rod. You can see the components or parts which are required to do a connecting rod assembly. So in that one, first part is connecting rod. Material is duraluminium. See, this will be the connecting rod, part number one. So top view, front view and side view we have, right? We'll see to do this one. So first we need to take this one. So for that one, I will go to first. So in this one, you need to do this feature. See this one. What do you call the dotted line? What you have, right? Using a revolve command, you need to do this one first, and the next you need to make revolve of this one. So front circular and the pin end circular. So you go to front view sketch. I will draw an axis line, horizontal axis line and vertical one axis line. Dimension will do afterwards. So the size of this one is, our height is 33. So you draw profile first. So this profile you can draw. You can make this join. Then by selecting the these two lines with the axis line, you can make a command as symmetric, and you can make symmetric for this one also. So we will make this one also symmetric. Next, we will draw the diameter first with respect to this one. What is the diameter as they given is 48. 48 will be the diameter, and height will be 33. Height will be 33 here. The given width will be, say here, this will be the 33. Next, it will be the 6.5 and 1.5. So, to this point is 6.5. So, what we'll do first? We'll get this one and these two. Rock. Then you can make a revolve of this one. Exit sketch. Go to revolve boss.
this axis as this vertical axis, and instead of making 360 degree, let us go to mid plane. So not the mid plane, go to blind, and here you can give 90 degree, and in direction 2, let us give 90 degree. So we got this one. Then here you can see the center distance. Center point is 1.5 mm away. So you need to cut that one. Take a top view, or you can select the face, sketch, make it normal, then draw a line. Just one vertical line is enough. Give dimension with respect to this one, and the dimension is 1.5. Enter. Then exit sketch. Once the exit sketch, make it isometric or diametric, right? Then go to cut texture. Select the line. You need to change this direction is outside. Then you need to make it through. So outside material will be going to cut. So here, because all the dimension is with respect to this face, that's why you cut that on initial step itself. Then go to again front view, sketch, make it normal, and you need to draw a pin. This circle again, you need to make a axis line, vertical axis line. Even you want horizontal axis line off to make it constrained. Then we will draw a line. This is not required. And draw a line from here. Say horizontal, taper, and taper, horizontal, vertical, horizontal, and vertical. So we need to make these two as symmetric. This line, center line, and the bottom line. Select all three by pressing the control button and make it symmetric. And even this one. So inclined line also you need to make symmetric. Then we need to give the diametrical dimensions. The inner diameter is 18. Here it should be 1. So this should be 18. With respect to end point of the tool, this should be 24, next will be 26. And last is the height. Height is given as 25. Here this one is 25. Here, it's still not correct. So what we need to do, we need to make this one constrained width and the dimension, select line and the datum point, make it coincident, we'll get, and distance we not given. So the center distance are given as, see this centers to edge of this face is 150. Let me give this one. So from the edge to center of that axis line, this should be 150. It revolve, and this should be 360 degree. Okay. Also done these two. Next we need to create a planes. The planes are required to make eye profile at two different location. We required in two different this width of 24 and width of 20. And this is the distance of 52, and here the distance is 150 minus of diameter. Nothing but half of diameter. So 150 minus 13. So we'll go to reference geometry, plane. Then I'll select the face directly. No need to set the plane, I will set the face. So automatically you can see the parallel plane is projected. We change the direction of the truck. Here, flip offset you can give. So it will change. And you need to give the value as how much? It should be 35, no? So initial first one is 35. Distance from the face. Now 35, it should be 52. You okay. Next we require one more plane. Again go to plane, select. Select the same face. So again show the in the flip offset. And we need to give the value as how much? 150 minus 30. 137. Next we can need to draw a profile, I section profile. Sketch, make it normal. Now you can draw a I section. Go to line, select. So you can draw a somewhere here. Then you need to draw an axis lines. One is vertical axis to mirror the sketch, one is horizontal axis. Again, that is also good to mirror. Now we will do the dimension. The diameter, the distance is 5 mm. So I take the axis line reference and I'll give this as 5. Next, overall width is 12. Next we have a 3 and 3.5. This inclination is 1.3, and the next distance is 3. Next we need to make these two symmetric, so we will take more axis line from the midpoint. I will draw this one up to this bottom axis line, then I will select these three lines and make it symmetric. Still it's not sure because we're not given the distance. This distance, overall distance is 24. So take an axis distance point and from this point and this value given as 24. So you can see the full constraint sketch. Go to mirror entities, select the lines, about axis line. Axis line should be bottom. Mirror about this axis line. View OK. Then afterwards, again you need to select a same mirror option. Draw this sketch. Then you need to add these two lines. Then at the mirror about this vertical axis. View OK. Now you got the full. This is at the distance of 24 mm at the plane of 52. Next we'll have the one more plane here. Again we need to sketch the same sketch by making normal this plane. We need to draw the same type of sketch. So for that one I will draw same way. Draw off of sketch the same way what we did previous. So we'll draw on vertical axis line also and even one should be midpoint. We need to delete this. This line should be midpoint of this particular line. It will take the previous sketch also. So don't take any reference from the previous sketch. also you can give the dimension. So we don't have an axis line, first to draw two axis lines so that we can look at this body. Proper dimension. I did sketch. So I have these two planes. This one should be 5 mm because it's constrained. I will take the previous line. What do you call it? Reference. So I will use this dimension first. It should be 20. Yes. The point that I need to delete. So make these three lines as symmetric by taking the reference of center axis and we need to give the dimension. This is 3 and the diameter is as they given 12 earlier. Let's go to mirror, select the lines about. We don't know about this horizontal axis. View OK. Then mirror it. Again, further turn, we need to go to mirror. Select the profile. Then select these two lines. Then mirror about is this one. View OK. Now we got this one. Both the sketches are ready. The next option is we need to make what I call the loft box. Select loft, select the both the sketches, right? The problem is now you can see that we not drawn the guidelines. If we didn't draw the guidelines, automatically it will take this kind of reference. So for that one, you need to pull these things and you need to match the same point. So I'll take this one. Drag one by one. If you drag directly to the okay, this we got, yes, should be same guidelines, or you need to draw in one axis line, so it automatically it will take that one as a guide curve. If you need, I will show that one also. I will end this command. So I will take the top view because we drawn the sketch. So I will go to sketch and I will take the reference as top sketch. Make it normal and I will take an axis line and draw from this datum point to this one. Just see the how it works. Sketch. Now we didn't do that much complexities. Exit sketch. So go to features, loft boss, select the profile, and even select the second profile also. Now you can click here and select the guideline as this axis. See? again is showing the same point error. So just pull this one and adjust it. Now we got the I section profile. Next we need to make it extrude. So again I will use the same sketch. Select this sketch, extrude boss. I will make it up to next, up to the next surface. Once we need to do again, you know, take the second sketch, you need to make it extrude, change the direction and make it again this one also up to next. So it will touch the contact mate with the next surface. Once this thing is done, now next work is we need to draw this profile. So make a top view, select the top plane as a sketch plane, make it normal and you can draw. Take a line from this point, draw a line horizontal, you need to match the profile what you have. Next, click somewhere here and stop. If you move the cursor near the point, you automatically change to curve. Then you can select this one as an end point. We'll do dimension afterwards. Convert entities, select this edge as a convert entities. Then take a line from here to up to this point, one more line and join this. Do okay. Then trim the extra line. Okay. Next, we need to give a distance dimension. So 12. Give this one as 12. Then we can give radius this one as 30. So this should be this point should at the edge. It should coincide with the end of the dimension command at this point and select the edge of this one and make it. Then you can draw a line. Okay. Then after this, you need to make the constraint of that complete sketch, right? So for that one, we require the distance, this one height. That can be taken from here, 60 plus 20. How 60 it is given and 20 is here radius 10 and this side radius 10. So it's 20. So I take the sketch. So 60 plus 20, 80. 80 divided by 2 is 40. Next, one more line constraint is required. Take a center line, axis line and draw a line to this merging point and give this angle with respect to any horizontal line or edge as 30. So see, multi sketch constraint. Make a texture. The thickness is given here. See, the thickness is 20 mm. So extrude. Select the mid plane option. View this one as 20. 20, not 2. Once that is done, next we need to make a fillet over here. So for that one, select the fillet command, select the round, select first this face, next top face, and the next is the right side face. So automatically it will make the complete round 2. So now we need to give the radius and anything. Next, we need to make a profile over here, right? The chamfered profile. So for that, we take a sketch, make it normal here, and you can draw here. vertical line from this point tangent line. So here normal so they given only the tangent details. So with respect to the tangent you need to make construction line, so horizontal line from the center axis, or you can constrain like this. You take the arc center, this will be the vertical, make it as vertical. This should be tangent and this point should be delete this edge. Line and the arc. So delete this line again. Not whether it was the line or not. Okay. Then take a line from this point. Tangent to this. See below the pencil symbol, I can see the tangent. When you see the tangent symbol, that time you need to make it clear. Then you can draw continuation of this one line till this and till this also. You can bring this. Make it normal again. Make horizontal. So what you do is select this profile, remove this, edit sketch, mirror, select the profile with respect to the axis line, view OK. Edit sketch, exit sketch, then you need to make a constant extrude of thickness they given as here 3 mm. This step you need to make. So extrude, select the profile, extrude sketch, view distances 3 mm. See, those two should merge each other. Fine. Once these things are done, the next work is you need to continue this profile, make a round cut, then you need to cut here. Take this one, it's the first sketch on that plane. Remember once again, sketch. So you need to select the, by rotating this one, you need to select this face. Make a sketch on that particular, that one is the plane part to draw a sketch. Make it normal. Now, you need to select the edge. So what we require? Convert entities, you need to select the, this one has already selected, make it control Z. Now go to convert entities, select the line, these two lines, not the face. Remember, only this line you need to select. Okay. Then take a line make it continuation, make it normal. Take a line and draw upward three distance. Anyway, we are going to cut that one. That is not the reference sketch. This is a very important sketch. What is in, it's in the black color line? Next, exit sketch. We need to cut revolve swept cut. So for that, it required a guideline. So I select the top plane sketch. Sketch, make it normal. Here I will select this curve and convert entities. Then what I do, I will extend this curve a little bit with the same radius. So it will use to cut the revolve cut or swept cut. So I will select swept cut, select the profile, then select the guideline. So you got the profile there also. The same profile. Next, I need to cut the extra material here to get this chamfer step. This step you need to make. So what I take, I will take a front plane sketch, make it normal. Take a line, draw from the end point, not the midpoint of the line. Intersection of these two, you need to select. Then some distance you draw horizontal line, then downward one line, misinclination, and end the line over here. These are all like a random sketch, how it is low profile looks. Then you need to give the dimension. This point dimension you need to give for this point, that is 35mm model from the front face. So go to smart dimension, select this face and point, and this should be 35mm high. View dimension is 35. Next will have the angle is there, that is 30 degrees. So select this and give 30 degrees. Okay, 30 degrees angle is done. Now we need to give a fillet radius here, radius 10. Okay, fillet 10, select these two lines, give okay. Exit sketch, we need to cut this one. So shortcut, select the through hole command, then do OK. So the material is cut. Now we need to make this one as mirror to downward. This plane is not required, we will hide this one. Then that cut textured, you need to make mirror. Go to mirror, select the feature, mirror. Then it lasts the plane, then please take the plane as top plane. Then you get the same profile at the bottom also. See, bottom also it is cut. See, when you see this one, you can see this profile. We require a radius also. You will see the radius. So, radius, go to fillet. The radius given as normal radius, we take radius as 12mm. 12 and select this along with select this also, and this can be done at the end also. Do now itself. We see afterwards. After mirror this feature and the feature to other side also. Then we do. Then next to that one we require to make a hole. This one. Select this face. Sketch. Sketch is not required. Sketch is not required because we go to hole wizard. Hole wizard. Go to option here. Straight tab. ISO. A type of thread you need to select the tapped hole. And size should be M10. M10 is given here. M10 of 15mm deep. So you need to select the here M10. Without any pitch, if you are given the pitch, then you need to select the required pitch, whether 1.25 or 1. If not given, you need to select only the M10. M10, don't give the length here. The length should be the given is for 15 is for the thread. So you need to give here it is 15. nothing but thread length. Automatically the length of the hole will be recalculated. Then you need to go to position, select this as a plane, make it normal. Then you need to move the cursor near the arc. It will show the center point of that particular arc. Then you select that point, then you OK. See, the threaded, this circle indicates the threading. Nothing but additional concentric circle, 3/4 circle, what you see, that is indicates the threading. So, hole is done. Next, we have one more hole here at side angle. Here, we require one more. For that one, you need to make, create a plane. Before that one plane, you need to make a draw a line first. So, select the top line, sketch, make it normal, draw a line. And give a dimension as this one should be 30 degree angle. With respect to any straight edge, you can give this one as angle as 30 degree. And length of the line you can give as 42 or something. Only thing it should come out from the top line. That one will tell you how much it should be. Or you can take this line, you can draw an axis line. And here you can draw normal to this one line. Right, we can make these two are perpendicular each other. In fact, the perpendicular each other, and you can give the dimension as the given as 3 mm. So hole size is 3 mm, then countersink diameter will be always double to that. So select this one as 6 mm. If the 6 mm is adjustable here, 6 mm means that side 3 and this side 3. So you need to have 3 mm. So it should not face off this one, this line, then it is okay. If you touch, you need to extend the length of this line. Clear? Then go to plane, select the plane. Just select the line on which you need to make a plane. It will show line, plane on a line. So we need to put a perpendicular to that particular line. So I did the perpendicular plane. When you select the perpendicular, you take the starting point. Now you take the end point, click it on the end point, so the plane will move to the end point of that line. So you require a plane over there, then give OK. By taking the reference of this one, you need to make a hole of what you call M3 countersink. So you go to again hole wizard. So here, don't take the tapped hole, just go to the countersink hole, ISO. I will select the initial option itself. Then instead of M10, I will go to M3, and here please remember the size of hole will be M3 and fit. If you give normal, here you can see the diameter is 3.4. If you give close, it's 3.2. If you give loose, it will draw 3.6. Nothing but the hole collard size, nothing but the threading size. So we need to go for a close, or even it can go to normal, not an issue. It's just a collard size. Let me see if we have a diameter size. Because we have to have a 3 mm diameter only center bot, but free hole with a countersink is not possible. It will take automatically threaded hole only. See, it will take automatically threaded only. We don't have any option, so we'll go to threaded hole. It's with the normal. Go to position, select this plane, make it normal, then select the data point only because it is normal to that one, right? You okay? Now you can see the hole. If you want to push this one to depth, then we need to make a record. This plane has to move downward. If you move the plane downward, then here you will get the difference amount. So this one is enough. Nothing to worry with respect to the countersinking. At the end, we can make this one here. We can make a chamfer little bit. Right? This can be taken as little chamfer, so it will take the depth. So go to let to chamfer. I'll view this one as 1 mm. So 1 mm chamfer. Need to select the entire profile. View. Some edge is not taking. You okay? Again, that is not possible. Delete. You okay? Let's see. This one is done. This is enough. Should have here also. But we are not getting it. It's just a prequel. Greasing hole. So then there is no any component is going to be assembled through that. That's why just the chamfer is enough that much. Then we have a hole at the bottom, 2.5 mm hole. So we need to make a 2.5 mm hole from the top. So let's select the, this one is the plane to make a drill. So anyway, it should be parallel to the drill. Go to, again, hole wizard. Size is 2.5. Just take a drill. Drill is fine, but if it is a contour sinking hole, it will be very difficult. Or in the previous one also, you make a drill itself. That will be better. Then it will edit feature. So we will go to drill. Now dwell hole. When you say dwell hole, it will be exactly the same size, right? Dwell hole and size should be M diameter 3, right? Then anyway, just select that face. Okay. Next, for that one, we'll do fillet. That will be the better chamfer. Go to, I will delete this chamfer previous which I have drawn. Go to chamfer, select. Select the edge, what will happen? It will take this end also. That's why you don't select the face. You need to select the edge only. So the this edge is not. Next we'll have this one. After this, as I said, the top hole. But hole wizard, drill of 2.5, 12 hole, standard position, make it normal, and you need to give a exact at the center point, then you need to give the dimension. Dimension is 11 mm. After giving this one, you can go to smart dimension, select edge and center point of the turn, and you can give the dimension over here. Then again, we require a chamfer over there also. So we'll go to, so here we have a chamfer both sides. See, that time you can directly select the face, select fillet. Let's select the face here. So we'll do the chamfer. So go to fillet option. So chamfer option. Then angle is the distance is 1 mm. Select here directly, you can rotate and select the face. So it will take full length. See both side jumper, it took here and bottom also. It's supposed to take off. It took here. There is a hole now, so it could not able to do this one. Edit feature, delete the face option, select the edge. And rotate here and you can select here also. Okay. We got the chunk on both sides. This is fine. Then after doing these things, then you need to make a mirror of all option what you did. So go to mirror features. Then axis is, you can take this one as with respect to the front axis. And options, we need to start from the plane what we created here. The boss. This one. Boss extrude, third one, then select, then boss extrude. You can see, click it on that one, it will highlight it. So if it highlight, then only you are selected. So you need to make double click. If you take click, single click, it won't take. Plane and sketch is not required, just go to on the features. So all the features, then do OK. Yes, we got the profile on other sides. Then we have a last option is we need to make here fillet. Go to fillet. The radius they given is, see this dotted line is 12. Fillet, make it 12. Select this head and rotate and take the bottom edge also. Or one side you can do and you can do the mirror, or at a time you can select the both. So both sides you get the fillet. Next we'll have the option is have a hole here. So you can make a hole. And this we need hole. So this face. So for that we need to make it create a plane above the top. So to record you need to go to planes. So this plane and give distance as 26 the diameter in the direction flip of U. Select this plane, make it normal. Of course, you can do go to hole wizard or simple drill and you can chamfer. You can do no need to go to hole wizard. Search, make it normal. Select, draw a circle of 2 point. What is the whole dia? Whole dia is 3 mm is all over. 3 mm, you okay. Then make it cut texture. Change the direction, it is showing opposite to that one. Instead of giving blind, you can give up to next. So, up to the next end, it will cut. Then you OK. Then you select option as chamfer. Here also you require a chamfer. Select chamfer. The same 1.5 1 mm. So I'll select both the edge. Because both are in a different plane. Let's sketch. And then more most of the features that make it keep it in isometric power or in diametrical view, and hide the lines which are not required now after completion of all the model. Whenever you want, you can make it show, and you can hide the sketch also. Then go to make it save. File, save. Create in a folder, make it properly so that all the parts which are required, everything should be saved in a single file. Clear? Okay. If you want, you can give the color. So normally we need to assign the material, and assign the material automatically, it will color will take place. So all the material is not available, so go to color edit. So right click on the part name, make it feature, clear the appearance. On the appearance, go to color, and there you can give the any color. So take this, okay. Then here the file name should be save. You are not given the file name, go to new again, save as the same folder. Give this one as a connecting rod. The file name has to maintain the same way what is available in the bill of material. Otherwise, when you after the assembly, when you create a drawing, if you download the bill of material, so then the names will be changed if you not save properly. If you save properly in the name what required in the bill of material, you will get the same names in the bill of material. Next part is bush.
Thank you. For further details, you can contact me, Sandeep S, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Canada Engineering College, Pantola. And my mail ID is sandeepmysore07@gmail.com, and my contact number is 9900092934. Any clarification or any information, you can contact me with respect to this video. Thank you once again.